Hey guys, Dan the Wolfman here with the one and only silver medalist, Olympic wrestler, and UFC fighter, Sara McMann. How's it going, Sara?
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. This is for ProMMAnow.com, for YouTube and my YouTube channel, Dan the Wolfman 1, and I'll throw it on the underground forum that Dana White was just posting at. And actually, Dana posting is why I just contacted you today. So first and foremost, we'll get to it. What do you think about Miesha Tate suddenly? Kat Zagano had knee surgery today. Miesha Tate getting the TUF coaching opportunity against Ronda Rousey and also the title shot.
I'm not actually that surprised because those girls were fighting for the title shot. So, you know, like anybody else that would have been scheduled to fight were just, you know, were regular fights, not exactly a title contention. So, you know, it's very unfortunate for Kat. You know, I'm sure that she is very bummed about missing this opportunity, but I kind of would have expected Miesha would be the replacement if you'd asked me before.
Yeah. So, is actually me contacting you, or today the first you've heard of any of this?
No, I got a text earlier today, and my Twitter feed has kind of been blowing up with, you know, tweets about it should have been me rather than her. So I've heard a little bit about it, but really I just haven't paid as much attention to it.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised then because, you know, I guess they knew on the 14th of this month, and Kat actually just had surgery and it went well, according to Dana on the Underground Forum. So, you know, I'm surprised personally that, you know, they didn't reach out to you and that, you know, I think it's a TV, looking at TV and viewership and drama versus who really deserves it. You're undefeated at 7-0. It'd be Olympian versus Olympian. Personally, I feel that, you know, you should have at least gotten the call first. What do you think about that?
Well, if they already knew who they had in mind and who they wanted to put on the show, it doesn't really make sense to call and offer an opportunity that you don't really want to give to somebody, you know. And I think that, you know, being on a TV show rather than just fighting for a title shot, mm-hmm. That's a different kind of beast. And, yeah, I think that someone like Miesha, you know, really wants that opportunity and is really more geared for that. And, I mean, personally, I would personally just rather have the title shot rather than going through the Ultimate Fighter. I thought that maybe I would have wanted it, but once I heard that Kat was out, it did solidify that I don't really want to be on the Ultimate Fighter. I mean, that might be bad. People might think that I'm ridiculous to pass up an opportunity like that if it were presented, but some things are for some people and not for everybody.
Right, so pretty much it's just you're not interested in the drama, you strive for the competition.
Yes, I really love the competition. And, you know, also I've gone through a lot of things and a lot of my personal life is already out for the entire world, and I would just like to keep a little bit of it personal. And I don't think that's too much to ask to chase my dreams.
No, not at all, and I think, you know, people understand that, but, you know, it's interesting. I think you should have gotten the call, but I understand it from somewhat of a business perspective, you know, but I'm not for someone coming off a loss. No offense to Miesha, I think she's a warrior. You know, Julie Kedzie kicked her in the face, and she came back and won that fight. I was there live for that, but, you know, I don't think coming off a finish loss, you should then get to fight for the title. I'm friends with Chael Sonnen, but I don't believe that he deserved to go up and fight John Jones either, and I think it's setting a bit of a bad precedent, even if it makes sense for, you know, TV ratings and drama.
I don't think that the UFC says that they operate on, like, a strictly title shot earned opportunity. You know, like, I think that they promote it like they have the discretion to choose who they want to fight for title shots. In wrestling, it's obviously different because you have to go through a tournament system, and I think even boxing has a little bit different, you know, standards or policies about, you know, getting title shots. But the UFC, you know, like, it's part sport, part entertainment, and, you know, like, it's not like this is the first time they've ever done that, and they run a good, successful business. So, I mean, I think that these decisions were made behind closed doors, you know, long before it got announced to the public.
Sure. Okay. Are you fine with that being kind of more the entertainment business, or would you like it better if things were a little more structured? I mean, recently they made official rankings that, you know, they put out on their website that, 100 media personnel vote on. Would you like it if it was structured a little more true sports way, so you understood the clear route to getting title shots versus just, you know, Twitter popularity or whatnot?
I don't know. I mean, I obviously prefer, like, a better system, but I think in any sport you can kind of get breaks that, you know, propel you to the top. But I really just try to accept what the UFC is. Like, I came into this sport with my eyes wide open. I knew it was going to be different from wrestling, and I knew it was going to have, you know, like that, just a different way that it operated. I understood it, so I just
try to accept it. Okay. So, what do you think? You got any predictions what will happen again if Miesha fights Ronda? Do you think Ronda will win that fight again?
I have no idea. Truthfully, I don't like predicting fights. I mean, 90% of the time I end up wrong. I lose all the battles of pretty good fights with my boyfriend when we watch the UFC, so I'm just a terrible picker at that. So really, it doesn't really matter to me. I think that they're going to put on a great show either way.
Now, do you have anyone you're scheduled to fight right now?
No, I haven't heard anything yet. I think that they're trying to line up a couple other of the female fights that, you know, they signed 15 women. I think they're trying to get everybody some good fights in there, you know, and spread it out. So I haven't heard anything yet. I'm just training to get better, and I'm focusing more on, you know, making me the best I can be rather than focusing on a specific opponent.
Okay. And, you know, you're 7-0 as a pro, I believe 2-0 as an amateur, according to the Underground Forums website and database. What were you, an amateur?
3-0
as an amateur. Okay, and 7-0 as a pro. I'd say your toughest fight was probably against Shayna Baszler. Would you agree with that?
Yeah. Well, yes, that was a very good fight.
And what do you think about other girls, like maybe her coming in or Sarah Kaufman? You know, you mentioned the people that UFC has recently signed, but they haven't really scheduled any fights yet, other than Liz Carmouche versus Miesha Tate. And, you know, now with Miesha, she should be getting a title shot. You know, I don't know if you'd be interested in fighting Liz Carmouche. You know, maybe, you know, that's a high-profile fight, perhaps. It might be good for your career because, you know, she fought in the first fight that got a lot of media attention, and it's a good stylistic matchup. What do you think about possibly taking Miesha's place to fight Liz?
I don't remember the exact dates that they were going to fight, so I would like a little bit of time to, like, you know, get ready for it. But yeah, I already, you know, had accepted a fight against Liz. I think that'll be a great fight. So, I mean, whenever they give me the call, I'll get ready.
Yeah. Well, yeah, sometimes you gotta kind of, you know, they're busy with 400 people on the roster. Sometimes you kind of have to pick up the phone and make, you know, stuff happen. You know, even for yourself, you're just a competitor. I get that. But even if you just want to make sure that you stay busy.
Yeah. No, my manager definitely is doing that for me.
Well, that might be a possibility.
Words from him.
Yeah, it might be a possibility. Let me see here. I believe that fight is scheduled. I thought it was scheduled for July 27th. Maybe that's not right. It looks like Julie Kedzie is fighting on that event. I'm at UFC's website now. See, it might have changed because I believe that they might have just changed it without putting much. I thought it was originally scheduled for July 27th, Liz Carmouche versus Miesha Tate. So, you know, looks like Julie Kedzie is probably the next, you know, female fight getting in there.
Alexis Davis has a fight before that.
Okay. And these are all, you know, really tough women. You've pretty much fought in a whole bunch of different organizations over your career, almost every single time. I believe you fought in Pro Elite twice, but other than that, you've kind of been hopping around. Are you looking, will it be nice to just to stay in one organization and kind of feel how it works and how each time it will be a little more familiar?
I think think that Invicta and Pro Elite try to run their shows very similar to how the UFC had their setup. And I think it's because those people worked with Supa before this. So actually, when I fought in the UFC, it felt very familiar because of the other shows I put on and how much they try to, you know, treat the athletes very well and have things very, you know, structured and timely. And but no, it's great because I think that the UFC, like what Strikeforce was before, is where the top level women in my weight class are. So that's where I want to be.
Okay, so there's really no one you're necessarily looking to fight next?
No, I guess I just don't think about it that way. You know, like, I've never had the opportunity to select out who I wanted to fight. So even now when people ask me, it's just an unfamiliar thing. Like, I want to fight all the girls in my weight class, you know, at some point. I mean, it really doesn't matter which order. If I, you know, fight a couple fights and then fight for the title, and then I fight them as title contenders or, you know, whatever. Like, I figure we're all going to work around and end up fighting each other at some point because the pool is so shallow. Like, there are only so many top-level women.
Right, and I don't think there's that many top-level women to necessarily contend for, you know, Ronda's title at this point. And many people would feel that, you know, you with your background, you know, given a couple more fights perhaps, giving you two or three more wins, that you are the person who's most likely to give Ronda a real challenge and potentially, you know, beat her, you know, just with the background of Olympic silver medalist in wrestling versus Olympic bronze medalist in judo. Do you feel you're pretty, it's inevitable that you will end up facing Ronda?
I'm 100% certain I'll end up facing Ronda. The entire goal of my career, I don't do anything that is not striving to be the absolute best.
Okay, and I think that's something that will be a huge fight media-wise and for the UFC, just with your Olympic backgrounds. I think that's something that would be very positive for women's MMA and something that would get, you know, a little more worldwide real sports media attention versus just how a female looks or her sexual orientation or other things. I think, you know, you versus Ronda and probably eventually two or three matches, perhaps a trilogy between you and Ronda someday will be, you know, the biggest thing really in the long run and for the long term for women's MMA and really kind of give it the legitimacy that, you know, it's kind of striving for. And Invicta's gone a long way, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, truthfully, I don't, you know, like, I'm not interested in rematching in trilogy as much as I want other girls to put in the time that, you know, like, the however many years Ronda and I have put in, and I want them to be strong title contenders. You know, like, I want my weight class and the other weight classes to have strong depth and, you know, like, everybody be very close to each other. Because that's what makes great fights, and that's what's going to, you know, propel our sport into, you know, complete acceptance of us as fighters. Not just, you know, I don't want just one or two selected out that are better than everybody else. I want everybody to be great.
Sure, and I mean, that's what all the, you know, fans want is close, real competitive battles eventually. And, you know, that's one of my takes is that I kind of don't like a few of the, I don't think title shots should be landslide 6-1, 8-1 odds, and things like that, which has been kind of happening recently and, you know, will likely happen. You know, I'm sure Ronda will be a huge favorite against Miesha again. I think it should be, you know, closer contested, and people will think it's a closer contested battle even going into it. So, you know, hopefully that will happen. And that needs to happen in the lower men's weight classes as well, you know, that are getting established. So, I mean, it's not just a woman's thing. It's a new, kind of a new division thing. You know, less of a pool, if you will. It's not, you know, international like competing wrestling was for you as much yet, you know, as far as how many are in the pool.
Yeah, yep. I think there are a lot of men and women that are working their butts off to make that happen.
So, well, I guess it's good to, you know, hear your side of things. It's interesting that, you know, you weren't offered it, but you probably wouldn't have been that interested anyway, just because you're more of a competitor than a kind of drama entertainer.
I would have probably said yes, but the the same desire would have been there if I would have just been said, hey, we want you to fight for a title shot. But I don't think I can turn down opportunities in my career that are like that, but it's not like I was jockeying for it.
Well, a lot of people, you're a mother, correct?
Yes.
You have a daughter?
Yes.
So, I mean, that might have been hard as well. I mean, how old is your daughter?
She's 4, and she would be entering school for the first time. So that would have been something that, you know, heavily weighed on my mind. And also, it would be very difficult for me to be separated from my daughter for that long a period of time. Like, she's a tremendous source of happiness, and, you know, like, I don't know if I could just up and leave for that long a period. That would be really difficult.
Yeah. Now, when she gets a little older, you know, I don't know if you're maybe not going to push her towards wrestling, but certainly I'm sure you feel wrestling is a great character building endeavor. You know, would you be happy if she gets into wrestling or perhaps competitive in something else, you know, judo or jiu-jitsu even, or, you know, something like that?
I kind of want her, like, I don't believe that kids should do, like, single sports when they're younger. I really am all for her just doing a bunch of different sports, like soccer, basketball, you know, like everything. And then when she gets a little older, she can decide which one she likes the most. But I think that it's kind of hard on kids' bodies to do the same sport since they're 5 years old, you know, and do it year-round. I think that's sometimes those kids peak in high school because their bodies are so, you know, worn out. So I would rather her just be fit and have a, you know, an athletic background, and then, you know, in like middle school or high school, then really choose a sport that she wants to focus on.
Okay. Well, you know, hopefully wrestling will come a long way and hopefully manage to stay in the Olympics. I know you've been pretty vocal about trying to get that support as has the whole wrestling community. So, do you feel support from the wrestling community now that you've transitioned into MMA?
Absolutely. A lot of wrestlers all the time come up to me and are like, oh, we're so proud of you. You're doing great. This is awesome. Like, they're very cool. And, I mean, like, I've had, like, other wrestlers in the MMA community that I see, like, people that I knew, you know, just, you know, knew them in passing at the U.S. Open level that are, like, going out of their way to help me, hook me up with different training situations, show me technique, take me to the airport. Like, just, they really are showing that wrestling is such a, you know, wide-reaching family that, I mean, I love seeing wrestlers in the MMA world.
All right, great. Well, we've been talking a while. I guess we should start to wrap up. Who do you train with, and do you have any specific ideas for upcoming fight camps? Is it going to change at all, and anything like that?
I train at Revolution MMA in Boiling Springs, South Carolina, and also with the Limestone Wrestling Team. But, you know, also I make trips to Marcelo Garcia's and to train with Zach McCoskey, and I train at TriStar. So, really, for me, you know, sports in general is more about, you know, battling myself, you know, my tendencies and, you know, overcoming my own demons than it is a specific opponent. So as much as I can, I wage that battle. And then if I'm announced against an opponent, I'll start training specifically for their tendencies and their holds.
Okay. And any comments on what it's like to roll with Marcelo Garcia or Zach Mikowski or any really high-level people like that? Because you're still relatively new to the submission game, aren't you? I mean, how long have you been training? 5-6 years, the submission game?
No, only 4 years.
Okay. So, I mean, it still must be pretty wowing, even with your, you know, wrestling control on base, to go with someone like Marcelo Garcia.
No, it is. It's unbelievable. The first time I went with him, he swept me like 30 times, and he just had the nicest little smile on his face. I started even laughing. It was just so ridiculous. Like, he is probably one of the most unbelievable athletes I've ever trained with, you know, and that's across the board. He's just phenomenal. And he's like, just so nice and pleasant while it's going on that you just feel, I don't know, you kind of feel like a retarded kid your first day. But, no, like, Zach Mikowski, like, he kicks my butt pretty good. Actually, a lot of the guys that I train with kick my butt pretty good, but apparently I must like it because I keep coming back for more, and it's great to come up there. Like, I can gauge my improvement, you know, very well by, you know, by taking time away, training with my regular training partners, and then go up to TriStar, go to Marcello's, and start applying some of the techniques that I've been working. And, you know, like, it feels almost like a competition to me. You know, like I go very hard, and I, you know, I really treat it like it's a competition, but a healthy competition, you know, like no injuries, just, you know, everybody trying to get the best, you know, out of themselves and each other. And so I give a little bit of butt kicking, but I take a whole lot more of them. But I think that's the way it should be while you're still progressing and learning. And if you're trying new things and you're putting yourself out there, you know, every once in a while you're going to get countered, you're going to get swept, you're going to get submitted.
Sure.
You know, I could stay in my tight little, you know, wrestler base and prevent them from doing things, but I would never get any better. So I go out on a limb and I'm trying new things and incorporating new technique, and, you know, some days are better than others, but, you know, I always learn from it, so...
How many fights and maybe how much longer, another year or year and a half of, you know, just overall training, grappling training, how do you think it might take for you to be able to dominate and defend the armbar from Ronda? You know, not only the armbar, but, you know, her tosses and wrapping around the head. There's certain specific things she does over and over again.
I already feel like I can do that.
Okay.
If they could call me tomorrow and give me a title shot, then I'd be fine with that. But I still want to be the fighter that I want to be. I'm getting a lot closer at that. Things are becoming a lot more natural. You know, like, my timing is getting better. My muscle memory, I've been even recently just making larger improvements in things that, you know, things that I felt like an incomplete fighter without them. So, you know, defending takedowns, defending arm bars, you know, That wasn't the thing that was, you know, ever holding me back. It's just getting the right amount of fights to earn a title shot.
Okay, and I think you know, 7-0, 4-0 as an amateur, you're definitely heading that way. I hope you fight in the UFC again soon. Would you like at the end of July, August, something? I mean, would you like to get in there fairly soon? You know, with 2 or 3 months notice.
Oh yeah, that would be great. I love to compete, so the sooner the better. That's definitely fine.
You know, I'm sure Dana will probably, or at least his people will watch this interview when I throw it on the Underground. You know, maybe that Liz Carmouche fight could open up for you, and I think stylistically that's a great fight, and she's got a name from fighting in the first, you know, UFC women's event. So, you know, perhaps you could do that, or, you know, a rematch against Shayna Baszler or Sarah Kaufman would also be interesting. You know,
I think Shayna's on the show, isn't she?
Oh, she might be. I think you're correct. See, you're better at the media stuff than I am. That doesn't quite seem right or fair as a TUF beginner show. See that some of the names seem a little too established and too experienced to be going with, you know, some fairly newer people with like a 3-1 record and stuff like that. So
I think that they did that because some people are, you know, like they're kind of coming on the closing end of their career. You know, like they've been fighting a very long time, and it's not enough to get them automatically in the UFC, because the UFC just is looking for like a different caliber, different type of athlete, you know. But it's enough to give them the tip of the hat to say, we'll see if you still got it in you.
Yeah, well, they stopped a couple of the, like, sort of names out there. I mean, like, Tara LaRosa, who, you know, deserves it. I don't know if she got on or not. I haven't seen the final list. I heard a yes, then a no. I haven't really paid enough attention to that. You know, and then they stopped Kim Couture because of her age. And then supposedly Tara LaRosa, they said because of her age, no at first. But then I heard possibly she might get in, and she of course deserves it. I think it's weird that all of a sudden there's like a 35-year-old cutoff range for the show.
Yeah, I don't think that there should be any age limit. It should be if you are still tough and competitive, because, you know, some people there, 26 would be done, you know, like they're just, I think that really the skills you have and the heart you have are what should really determine that, not the age number.
Well, two quick last questions. Did you ever get a chance to roll with GSP?
No, I have not. Both times that I've been up there, he's been in training camp, so I definitely try not to bother people while they're in training camp.
Sure.
They're also significantly bigger than I am.
Yeah, okay. And what's is there anything off the top of your head that people might not know about you, or they might find, you know, kind of quirky, just personal stuff, anything that you're into, any shows that you're into, anything like that?
Not that I can think of. I mean, I don't know.
Okay. Any website or any website or Twitter you want to plug or anything?
SaraMcMann.com and Sara_McMann for Twitter. And I have an athlete fan page on Facebook.
All right. Great. Thank you very much. I'll be shutting off the recorders now. Thanks.
Okay.
Guys, go to ProMMAnow.com. Subscribe to my YouTube page at DanTheWolfman1. Go to thecombatsystem.com and learn some real catch wrestling and MMA moves. Thanks.